Hi, everyone. My name is Rustem, and today I want to tell you about how to leverage machine learning inference for generative AI models on AWS. So we're entering a new era of AI where large language models are becoming a commodity. So you don't need to build them from scratch to use them. There is low barrier to use or integrated with the existing applications, and no requirement for machine learning expertise. And it can be used for different applications like augmented workforce, basically as personal assistant or for solving day-to-day tasks, as a core product, and you don't need a large team to start, and you can get very early feedback, and as a support tool for existing product, because it's very easy to embed AI features, and it can help to reduce the cost of manual processes. So the agenda today is the following. We will start from machine learning inference challenges. Then we will compare different options for machine learning inference at AWS. Then I will show you demos for SageMaker JumpStart and AWS Copilot for machine learning inference and large language models. And finally, there will be a summary of the findings today. So when you want to organize your machine learning project, you have to start with business understanding, then go through the process of collecting data, then you build your model, then you deploy it, and then you get feedback from customers. But actually, the data science process is very iterative, and you want to be able to start fast to gather customer feedback. And for large language models, you want to be able to use this feedback to retrain your model more effectively. So when you want to deploy machine learning inference, usually the main challenges are that you have to adhere to production requirements, aka latency, load, and cost. You want to be able to scale, and you want to be able to start early and integrate with your existing infrastructure. With large language models, we have two more challenges, because large language models consume a lot of memory and compute, and usually there are very specialized inference frameworks which you have to use. If we look at the machine learning inference stack, we will see that we basically need to cover a bunch of stuff from hardware side to model side, and let's take a look at each specific step here. So with model, usually two parts here, like first is storage, basically where do we store the model. It could be part of the container image, it could be S3, or it could be some sort of registry. For example, private, JumpStart, or Hugging Face. In case of large language models, when you want to choose a model, you need to basically understand what number of parameters you can support, and what model type and potential fine-tuning. And finally, which optimizations you need to apply, like precision, pruning, or distillation. On the code level, there are also multiple options. One option is no code at all, meaning that basically this part is abstracted and you just run your model directly. But if you need to implement some code, usually it's for inference itself, for managing prompts, handling some business logic, or handling some networking connections. On the container level, basically, usually the main decision is to choose inference libraries. For example, it could be text generation inference from Hugging Face, VLLM, or LeetGPT, or others. And also you need to decide on base image and packages. And finally, on hardware side, basically you need to understand what kind of hardware you want to use and what is how to balance speed, cost, and scale. And the limitation here is large language models are RAM and compute hungry. And depending whether you want to use GPU or CPU, you may need to use different optimizations. With GPU and extremely large models, you may need to have parallel model serving. And with the CPU, there may be some specific optimizations for CPU to be able to handle large language models. So now, once we went through the inference stack, we can basically put it together with different inference options and understand like on this stack, which parts user needs to control and which part is controlled by AWS. Here you can see in orange what is controlled by AWS, aka abstracted from the user, and what user needs to organize. So some things to note here. So all SageMaker options use the same SDK to deploy and manage, and they generate the same inference endpoint. So the advantage here is basically whatever option you're using, and you are flexible to go between them, because in the end, you will get the same infrastructure. So now let's take a look at all these options in more detail. So first, let's start with SageMaker Inference Endpoint. This one is basically deployed from SageMaker SDK. You can customize number of instances and instance type. Load balancing is handled by SageMaker, so you don't have to worry about that. And model itself can be referenced in different ways, as I will show you on the next slides. And by itself, it has multiple options like asynchronous inference in case you don't need real-time endpoint, batch transform inference, or serverless inference. So next is SageMaker JumpStart, which is basically a collection of models which you can deploy in a single click. And what it does, it will deploy SageMaker Inference Endpoint, and it supports public and proprietary models. A specific section of JumpStart covers foundational models. Basically, this type of models can be deployed from both SageMaker Studio, but also from SageMaker SDK. And model can be referenced by IT and can even be fine-tuned without a single line of code. Next is SageMaker Hugging Face Estimator for large language models, also deployed from SageMaker SDK. And the advantage here is that models can be referenced either by Hugging Face repo or S3, and they would use specific deep learning container optimized for large language model inference. So now let's go through the code for different options and see how it's different. So first is JumpStart example. As you can see here, it's basically three lines of code. We just reference model by using model ID. In this case, it's Falcon 7 billion parameters model. And we just need to set up number of instances and instance type. Next option is Hugging Face. A bit more complex, but you can see here that we also have more customizations. So we can reference model from Hugging Face repo, and we can customize framework versions. But model itself, we can set up in the same way. And next is custom Docker image. Here we need to provide basically a link to model, link to Docker image on ECR, and a bunch of other stuff. But generally, deployment itself would be very similar. So as you can see here, like even though like these are different ways to deploy models, they're very similar. So now let's cover ECS cluster and AWS Lambda. With ECS cluster, basically what you get is your classic cluster with different machines and load balancer and auto-scaling group. It's very flexible, but usually it's very high threshold to start with. The advantage here is that it can be deployed with AWS Copilot, which will manage all the infrastructure for you. The limitation here is that it's limited to Fargate workloads, but here you can see a link where you can check the blog post about deploying machine learning inference using AWS Copilot. Next option is AWS Lambda, which is very scalable, but has challenges with cold start. It can be integrated natively with other AWS services, but it's also limited to only CPU workloads. There is an option with NapStart, which can reduce cold starts. And Lambda and the other infrastructure can be deployed with AWS SAM framework, which is focused on serverless workloads and AWS. So not that now that we have covered different inference options, you can see here that basically we have a lot of options on AWS. And depending on what you want, you can either start very early or you can have more flexible infrastructure. It's your choice. If we want to compare these options in a very straightforward way, basically on the left side, we have more control over scaling and lower level stack. And on the right, we have options to easily start with just model without worrying about underlying infrastructure. And the main advantage here is that it's not a decision which is set in stone. This stuff can change through the project lifecycle, depending whether you want to use custom model or let's say you want to use custom code or library, or you fine-tuned your model and now you want to use your fine-tuned model. Next part, which I want to cover, is using CPU for large language models. When we speak about large language models, usually we speak about a large amount of memory we need to use. For example, 7 billion parameters with a half precision floating point, it's 14 gigabytes. And that's a lot of memory. But as you saw before, Fargate can support up to 100 gigabytes. Sometimes you have CPU optimized frameworks, for example, llama.cpp. And to make model work successfully on CPU, you may need to apply additional optimizations. So now let's switch to demos. So first, I will show you how SageMaker JumpStart will work with Falcon model and deploy SageMaker inference endpoint. And then I will show you how ECS Fargate with AWS Copilot will work together. Feel free to check these demos on this link. Let's start by looking at the JumpStart example. So here you can see notebook, which is hosted on SageMaker, and the code which I shared before, basically just three cells to deploy the model itself. We can see the endpoint here, and the similar endpoint would be deployed with other SageMaker options. And you can see here that once it's deployed, I can just provide prompt with additional parameters and get the response right away. Now let's take a look at AWS Copilot option. So here you can see basically I already deployed it with Copilot deploy because usually it takes some time to deploy it, but I can basically run similar prompt to the endpoint link in a request and get similar response. So here you can see how the cluster would look like on AWS dashboard. Basically, one active task and machine. And the code is actually very straightforward. The structure of the project is basically just two folders, one with basically configuration file, which will have things like how we build Docker image and CPU and memory we want to provide to the machine. And the code itself, which uses transformers library, loads the model from the model file, and just parses the request and produces the response. So very simple. And very simple Docker file, which just installs requirements and runs the application. So to summarize, AWS has a lot of options to start with deploying large language models in production with different levels of customization depending on your project. SageMaker enables you to evolve your machine learning infrastructure over time, depending on your needs. And stay tuned for updates from AWS for other options for large language models. Here are the links to different courses, blog posts, or GitHub projects, which I mentioned throughout the slides. Thank you very much for your time and would be happy to answer your questions in the comments.